Welcome to Trading Lounge and the US indices for Monday, July 7. So I don't have any answers of the bigger picture. I know that we've got a good possibility of pushing back up into the 4,000, and we'll look at that particular trend there. But I just wanted to talk about a few other things before we get there in that space. Now, one of the big things here, of course, is that the market's been in a downtrend. It's hit this number here where it's vibrated somewhat. And it's quite normal for a market when it moves through, eventually move through the level, migrate through it, then to retest it before moving lower. That's all quite normal. But also a lot of the time too, it can find support back on the 4,000, in this case, the 4,000, and then make a move to the upside. Or it could attempt to look for support on top of the 4,000 and fail at that point and then move down. There's really a lot that can go on here, and there's a whole stack of different ways to count this particular trend here. So I don't really have any answers at this particular point. All I can do is pick trends on the intraday basis, you know, for a while until the bigger picture comes clear. Because even if we looked at this move down here as an A wave, a B wave, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 here as a C wave, and we've got a low in here, then we would need to see, well, the 4,000 as support as the first thing. And then we would also need to see a structure that would sort of suit that as well. One of the questions that come up is that, well, is this move here, is that in 5 waves or is that in 3 waves to the upside? Well, I think there's a good case for both of it, actually. If I just use the SPY, I mean, I prefer to use the SPX, but it's not on this particular platform. So in this instance here with the SPY, we can count it down as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 here and have a low in place. Or we've got the bigger bearish picture, which is still in play too, where we can have down for wave 1 here, back for wave 2, down for wave 1, back for wave 2 here, and then further down at that point. And we'll look at that again. It's also possible to put wave 2 over here, and if it does make a new high here, there's a few different ways we could look at that here. And as a wave 2 here, this would have to be an ABC correction to that point. But if we put it over here, then it's okay to be in 3 waves at that particular point in time as well. So yeah, there's a lot going on here, but I just wanted to sort of focus in on this little move here for a few moments, because, you know, I've been racking my brain with it as well. In that, I mean, at first glance, in the bigger picture, when you look at it, it looks like we've got a move up here, a consolidation, and then another move up here. Having the spike here doesn't really help that much either with all of this, but I can count it on this thing as 5 waves up, as 1 and 2, and then 1 and 2, and 1 and 2, and 3, 4, 5, the 3rd, 4th, and 5th for the 3rd, so the 2nd to the 3rd, 4th, 5th for 1, ABC for 2 here, and then up for 3, 4, and 5. When I do look at this on another platform, not a platform, just the web-based thing that's got the XP, the S&P, what's the name here. So in this case here, if I look at the move coming to the upside here, then I could look at it in this case from this low down here and look at all of this as wave 1 here and 2 here. That's all pretty clean in that way. And then 1 and 2 in here, and then 3, 4 and 5 for the 3rd wave, the 4th and the 5th. So I can count 5 waves up here. It does leave the 5th as a little bit small in that case. And also coming down here, you know, makes it a nice ABC to this point. But we can see this, yeah, well, to this point, we can look at it as an ABC pattern here. The other question is, so this particular move here, it looks like 3 waves, but it can be counted as 5 waves. So that's one thing that has been sort of holding the count up a little bit. The other point is this whole move here on the NASDAQ, it's clear that we got 5 waves coming down here. And I can count 5 waves coming down here on the SPY as well for that. It's interesting on the S&P 400, for example, and this would also be for the Russell as well, is that that move that's come down here, then we've had this move here. In most cases, well, with the NASDAQ and the S&P, it hasn't made a new low below here. So we've been able to count it as one and ABC for two here, with possibility. But in this instance here, it can't be counted like that. And the Russell's like this as well. It made a new low below here. So in this case, we could look at it as an A wave here, a B wave here, and a C wave here. And that would make sense. And perhaps we need to migrate, you know, the S&P 500 to that particular point. That count, you know, and then looking at this here we'll look at that. But as it stands for the S&P 400 here, the mid cap, we've got one and two here, one and two and three and four and five for the third wave to here, then the fourth, and then a small fifth wave here. Well, it doesn't have to be the fifth wave here. It could be a part of a larger wave four here, a wave three here, wave four here, and then a wave five to the upside. So this is also not that clear at the moment, but I just really wanted to look at this. In this case here, we could look at this as one and two and three and four here, perhaps, or it doesn't really count, but like that does it, one and two and three, four, five, and it's all sort of corrective at that point. Trying to understand this with a bit more clarity and understanding this with a little bit more clarity still doesn't really leave us a lot of possibilities at this particular point in time. So coming back to the SPY here, the other point here that we need to make is that, as I just mentioned, we can look at this as wave two over here. Well, first of all, we can look at this as what, having a low in place like we just did. So if we just come back to the, was it 10k tick or one day, I'm not sure here. Yeah, so in this case here, we can still have the big bearish count for the S&P with wave one here and two here for that, and then down for wave one here and coming back for wave two here. That's still a possibility at this point. All right, so that's there. It's also possible to have this here as an A wave, a B wave, and a C wave to move down here as well. So this is where we've also got to be careful, and then having a move to the upside here again after that. So an A and a B and a C wave here. So let's just go back to that 10 tick chart. So as you can see here, you know, in this case, if we use this above the level here, then the A wave and A, B, C for the B wave here, and then one and two. And then in here, we've got one, two, three, four, five for one and two here, three here, four here, and five here for third wave, fourth wave, and fifth wave here. A little bit small for the fifth wave, but the third wave was also not that fantastic in terms of comparing it to wave one. So it is diminishing up here in that space. So it's possible to call that top in there as wave B. So I can put wave B here, or we can have it as wave two. Now, as wave two, of course, we would end up with a bigger bearish picture down here, and that would be that. As wave B here, we would end up with wave C here. In both cases, this here as wave B or wave two here, they would both end up being the same in a way, because if we do come down here, that would be five waves down for wave one, and then we would come back for wave two, and then we can short the B wave within that. So if we came down here with five waves, then we can look to short the B wave here. This B wave here, we can look to short that. We can get a position earlier in here as well, but we would short this B wave here. So that would be the downside projection for this. But like I said, we also need to be careful, because this can be looked and viewed as an A and a B and a C wave to this point, and then have a move up there. And then, you know, we get sort of sucked into that. So the five waves down here doesn't necessarily mean it's wave one. It can also be wave C at that point, if that is indeed the case, because we haven't taken the top out here. This is really quite big here, so it's possible for it to, you know, continue to the upside at that point. It does appear with the stock market, if you had a look at that video today, then it does appear that we've still got a bit further upside to go. And as I mentioned, this wave four here can pretty much go over here. So this could get a bit more complicated within this space here before sort of heading higher at this point. So we can't really do much today on this unless we see Monday pushing higher at this point to buy new highs here for that. So let's just see how that goes. This needs to go back over here. But I want to, now I've just talked about that, because I wanted to talk about this space in here. So first of all, as I just mentioned, then we talked about being five waves up here, or three waves. So it looks like five waves, but can be counted as five waves. It looks like three waves, but can be counted as five waves. The other point here too is that we haven't made a new high above the top here. So we can have this as wave two, and then wave one here, and wave two here, and then continue down at this point. The stock market looks like it wants to push up here. But this is really all a game of this number here, finding support or not finding support. And as I mentioned, it's natural for it, once it falls through here, to go back and retest it at that in that space. So when we look at, let's just go to the bigger picture here for a moment. Let's just go to, the reason I want to go to the monthly chart for is not to look at targets to the downside, but just to keep an eye on the stochastics down here, because it is down here quite deep, isn't it? So in a way, you know, to be bullish, this is lagging here. To have support on the 4,000 would be the right thing to do. When we look at the weekly chart, it will be flatlining at this point, because it's taken out. When indicators do flatline like this, when they take previous lows out like that, so they're not much sort of chop at that point. So you've got to kind of treat the stochastics as sort of being clean and get those clean moves here. Once it starts doing this flatlining, then you have to go to the monthly. We can see from the monthly that we still need further to move down. But at the same time, indicators lag as well. So that's a bit of an issue, but it is down here. And it doesn't mean that that is the low. We could certainly have a little move up and then another move down here for that to play out as well. I'm just pointing out that where it does appear that we've got some sort of low coming into play shortly for this. And will it come in early? Will it come in now at the 4,000 and find support here for this? Well, it's possible, but we're not really seeing this here as a Monday's open for the Asian session or for global markets. It's just after 8 o'clock. This is not pushing up that strong, is it? Do you know what I mean? I mean, when you look at those bars there, we can say that, well, they're okay. They're, you know, they're moving along okay, but they're not really pushing up strong, are they, in this space? So that is a bit of an issue at this point. And, you know, when we're under a level, I tend to look for short trades. And in that case, we would look, you know, we start from the bottom and build a case to the upside. So we would start here, and then we would look under here, and now we need to find some sort of low over here to build on. Do you know, to look for that short side of things? We've talked about being long in all of this, and we've got a little bit more to the upside to go in this. But in terms of bigger trades, you know, I wouldn't go long unless I had, you know, a nice classic trading levels pattern sitting on the 4,000. It's that simple, really. That would be the safe bet at that point. So, and we're a long way from that. We haven't even arrived here yet for that, you know. So yeah, it's a little bit sort of tricky in that sense. So anyway, let's sort of cruise. What I wanted to do today was just really talk about the market's not in a bullish pattern or a bearish pattern. I don't think that anybody could actually call which direction that we're going to go from this point with any real clarity and, you know, put their house on it, so to speak, at this particular point. It's just not there yet. We don't have a clean move to the upside here. This move to the downside here, as I explained, the Russell and the mid-cap 400 has made a new low here. So I think we need to treat this as also an A and a B and a C to here rather than wave one and two in that space. But let's go to the intraday. The first intraday is the bigger bearish pattern, which from the top of the market up here, looking at it as wave one and two here, and then five waves down for one, ABC for two here, and then moving down further, looking at this here as wave one here, and wave two sitting over here for that. If we do make a new high over here, we could also look at it as wave two, because this particular move here, as I mentioned, it looks like three waves, and it sits better with me as three waves, but can be counted as five waves. So it's possible to put wave two over here. In the meantime, staying with this count here of one and two here, then we can also stay here with wave one here and wave two here. Now, if we get any more highs on this here, then we can eliminate that particular count. So if we get a new high above here, for example, then we can rule out that wave two there, okay? But as it stands, it can stay in place here. And don't think, you know, because the market's just coming down now, it may or may not be bearish. But if we were going to short this, what we would need to see would be a nice, I'll just keep it simple, nice five waves down here somewhere, wherever that may be. And then we would need to see that correction at that point, and then we can look to short it at that point. Of course, you could short it now and put the stop above the top here. There's nothing wrong with that as well. But that's more of a bet rather than using analysis on this. But I suppose, in a way, we've got this here as an A wave, a B wave, and then one and two and three, four, five. We'll have a closer look at that. But we talked about it with the SPY, and that's how it count out here. So an A wave, a B wave, one, two, three, four, five for third, fourth, fifth for the C of either wave two or wave B here. But the stocks, as I mentioned, have still got a good case for having another move to the upside. So don't be too quick to jump to the downside on all of this here. And if we now go to the let me check. Okay, so this was 2K tick here, and this is where we were looking before. So in this case, we are looking at it. Well, first of all, this wave five may not be there. We've been looking at this and stock as being wave three here, and also wave four coming up above here. So that's another way to look at it. And we can also look at it as being a low in place and look at it as wave one and two here. And in this case, we haven't made a new low here, so we can look at it as wave one here with an ABC pattern for wave two. And in here, we've been looking at this here last week as wave one and two and one and two. And then we can see a nice little strong third wave in the middle here. So if that's the third wave here, then we've got the fourth and the fifth here for the third. And then this here would make the fourth wave here. Now, this fourth wave should be bigger than this fourth wave. So this is a nice little A, B, and C. It's a nice little A, B, C pattern, that one. So an A and a B and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 here for that. Then 1 and 2 and 3, 4, 5 to finish. So this one can pull back to this one here, the fourth wave of one lesser degree, or the 38.2% retracement level. So, but this, yeah, it's a bit small to put wave four in here. So I just think give this a little bit of go here. But the good thing here now, if you wanted to go long here, then all you need to do is find support on the 3.9 or take the top out. Well, I should say take the top out first, but then you need to refine it here as a little classic trading levels pattern to come in here. So instead of taking the top out here, there will be another small high that you can go on to, which will be this high and then this high over here. That's the way to treat that at that particular point. So let's just see if this develops support down here somewhere for that, and then moves up into wave 3 of 3 and 4 here for this. Now, if we were not using this as wave 1 and A and a B and a C for wave 2, if we have to bring this over to this point here like we had to do, well, we can look at on the Russell, but on the MDY here, it made that new low here. So in that case, we can't really look at that as wave 1 and 2 here. We've got to look at this as 1 and 2 and build it up from that point. So if that is indeed the case here, then this wave 1 here would need to come over here for that, even though it hasn't made a new low here. It doesn't, as a corrective wave, we can have that as an A wave, a B wave, and a C wave here, and that's fine at that point. So all I'm saying is this can be counted differently here, just depending on how you do that. But still, whichever way you want to sort of look at it, we still left with wave 1 and 2 here, and wave 3 here, and wave 4 here, and wave 5. It's just that depending on how you count this down here, you would end up with two different scenarios. So one, you'd have this high here, and then wave 4, and then wave 5 here. So we've either got this is the top or this is the top. You know, I'm hoping that we get up here to the 4,000 and that we have five waves, either be it whichever direction, doesn't really matter to me, but I just hope we get, I hope we see a classic trading levels pattern here. That's what I'm sort of hoping for, but will we get that or not is a different story here. And, you know, with a lot of stocks like with Apple and so on, we can count lows in for Apple, but we can also count this move up here as a wave 4 from many stocks as well. So that's also a possibility here. It's also a possibility that if we do call a low in here, just to make things a bit more complicated, as I explained with Apple today as well, is that even though we're moving up here for a wave 4, this A, B, and C here may just be the A wave here. This is something else that we need to bring into line here. So we could have those five waves up to here, right? And there's two things that can happen here. So basically what I'm saying here is an A, B, C here for the A wave, and then a B wave, and then a C wave to come down. So this move here, even if it's not really moving off like a third wave here, it's more, it's moving like a corrective wave. So we could have an A, B, C here for the B wave, get a reaction from here as a B wave here, another B wave here, and then a C wave up here for this, and then come down at that point too. So there's a lot that can actually play out here with all of this. I don't really have any answers just yet. I'm still sort of thinking about it. It's not, you know, I'm not really getting sort of any answers in here for this. And this could play up here as five waves too, as 1, 2, 3. It's not really pushing up that well. I mean, this same count with Apple here, for example, Apple's pushing up a little bit better, but is that strong enough to give me a third wave of 1, 2, 3 here? Because that would have to give me wave 3 up here somewhere, wave 4, wave 5 here for that. And then I'd still need an ABC pattern to come back into play, and then another 5 here, and then down again as well. So, you know, all of these stocks here, you know, it's okay to call a low in, but we still may get trapped in a bigger B wave over here with all of this. You know, it may or may not be the case. It'll be interesting to see if, first of all, if we do get five waves up here in stocks, and or we just get three waves, because even if we got an A and a B and a C here, we can come back for the B wave and then go up for the C wave and then come down again as well. So all these counts are valid, and I know it's pretty annoying to look at them all because we just want answers, but you know, at certain times there are no answers. Well, I don't sort of have any. Nothing at this point is set in stone or is clear at this point, you know. I'll just go back to Apple here as an example. I think, do I have this on 100 ticks or 10 ticks or something? Yeah, so it's the same here with, you know, with the S&P and the NASDAQ, and that it looks like we still need to come up here further to finish off. It's like we've got wave one and two here, but we don't see, with wave two, you know, is here, but we don't see any wave four here yet. You know, that's what I'm thinking here. So I think that we, you know, we're on the right track. We'll get five waves up. It's strong in the middle here. There's the beginning, the middle, and the end up here, but we don't, there's no fourth wave sticking out of this trend here so far. So we're not finished to the upside yet, I think, with stocks, you know. But even when we get up here, it doesn't mean that we're finished with the fourth wave either. We can come back to this level or this level and then push up again into a bigger corrective pattern. There's a lot going on here that we, you know, that I can't sort of pin down just yet for these, unfortunately. So the NASDAQ, I won't go into a lot of detail, but with this is that we can look at, we can count this. If I put this B wave or wave two here or here on this, as I mentioned with the mid caps on the S&P, we're still left here. So if I just go from here, then we've got one and two here and three. We still need wave four here and wave five to the upside. I suppose we can look at this as wave one here and two here, three, four, five, and be finished. It's possible. If the 12,000 becomes the retested resistance, well, then we can look at that. But in the meantime, that move from here to here, that can pull back into, well, okay, that's okay, yeah. So if the 12,000 becomes the resistance, then we can start looking at being sort of on the bearish side of this. But yeah. I think there's still just a little bit more upside, but it's going to be a problematic area because of the old high here. So we can go one and two here, and then one, two, three, four, and five for the third wave, which would basically suit Apple more. This is sort of the Apple count here, because if I just bring Apple back across, see, Apple doesn't have that, this sort of thing that could be taken both ways here. Here it's pretty clear. It's just up for one here, back for two here. So that's why I'm thinking we've got three, four, and five to go up here. So I think that's the same as this market here, even though that we will see, we can see something, you know, moving like this. That could be a high, or we have one more high in here. Either way, there's still further upside to the NASDAQ. So, yep, that's that. And much the same with the Russell as well here in that, well, in this case, as I mentioned with the S&P 400, this low here takes out that low here. So we'd have to look at this as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for the A wave, the B wave, and the C wave here, and then look at 1 and 2. And then we're going up for 1 and 2. We're counting up here. Last time we spoke of 3. The wave 4 got a bit big and ugly, and then wave 5. So we're in wave 4 here. You know, do I put wave 4 in here, or do I put it over here? Is it going to give me something like this first, or and then that, you know? But yeah, it's just not finished to the upside. That's the takeaway at that point. What have we got for the Dow? The Dow's also taken that low out here. So, but it's pretty hard to count this because it's taken the low out here, right? It's, I suppose we could go an A, a B, and a C wave up here, but even that was the case, we still need another move to the upside here that is going to test that high there. So it's kind of what's happening at the moment on that bigger bearish picture that we've got. I can see the boundaries of that being tested now. So it would be nice to be able to eliminate that huge bearish count that we've got, you know. That would be sort of step one, you know, take the heat off the market. But it's still, you know, we'd still be in a larger corrective pattern over here for this. So yeah, we'll just see how this goes at this point. What have I got there? I've got that as a wave C here, an A and a B and a C wave here with one and two. Yeah, possibly. Anyway, I'm not going to turn bearish unless I see a nice, clear five-wave structure to the downside. And don't think that you're missing anything if that is going to be the case, because we'll just wait for the rally, and then we'll move in at that point. So we need to confirm that we've got five waves down here, because as I mentioned, you know, Apple and Nvidia and all of those guys, they seem to be still needed to complete their move to the upside. It doesn't look like a big bullish picture here either, does it? This is really struggling to move up. So I don't think we've got a low in place. I think that we're in a bigger correction. That's what I'm thinking. You know, I'm thinking that we're in something like this here. I think this is going to be more corrective over here. I think that's sort of where we are. So it's going to be a bit of a nightmare, really. It's just going to take time to figure it out. The puzzle's just got a bit more complicated, I think. That's the issue that we're in here. So, yeah, just be a little bit careful with all of this. We won't be doing much trading in all of this. If I see something that's, you know, easy, well, then we'll do it. But this, you know, if we're calling this as a low here, we're just not really getting this powerful move in here. That's the thing. But at the same time, that bigger bearish count that we've got for this market, which is on this 10K chart here, as going down for 1 and 2 and 1 and 2 and 1 and 2, I don't think that's the case either, because I know that stock, we're pushing the boundary. I can't rule this count out just yet, you know. And like I said, even if it goes up here further, I can still call it wave two. It's a little bit big as a wave two for this particular structure here, but I can't rule it out. But the whole thing's not looking like a big bull market with a low in place, and it's also starting to not look like 1 and 2 and 1 and 2, but it's still possible. We could even go to wave two here, as I mentioned, and still have that bigger bearish picture. It's sort of looking like we've got some bigger complicated sort of correction that's going to play out, something that we're not expecting, you know, something like this, you know. We'll see, but there's nothing, I can't see anything here just yet, but anyway, that's it. Alrighty, cheers.